Alright, hello everyone, here we are. We are past the next game day. We're gonna talk to Masad again. Hopefully the game will let us go forward. Yes!
Miro, why such a sour look on your face? It is wholly unbecoming. But please, I am more than willing to lend an ear if it would help you absolve you of your worries. I've got all the time in the world, after all. So tell me, what troubles you this fine day?
Meeting the Leafkin Queen.
Ah, yes. Her Royal Highness, if you will. Should you have the time, I would enjoy nothing more than to regale you with some of the relevant tales of old. But before I do, have you ever had the fortune, or perhaps misfortune, of tussling with one of the Nakuals? I am certain you have at least heard of their existence. Guardians of Ubuka, her wrath made manifest. If you wish to progress into the wilds, locking horns is inevitable. Be that as it may, I promised you a story, and a story you shall have. Having spent many days and nights in Adelin, you have surely heard the name of the founding king spoken by noble and peasant alike. The trials and tribulations of centuries past are naught but legends to people living today. This story involves one of these legends. The foolhardy king ventured into the wilds with his entourage, invading the lands of Ubuka and slaughtering all foes in his path. Though his blade sliced through the flesh of many like strands of silk, a few particularly lurid beasts, those that now serve as keepers of the wilds, were not to be tamed so easily. When they were at last bested, they swore fealty to the Founder King. Today, we refer to them as the Nakuals. He subjugated one race after another, eventually breaching the sanctity of the forest's most inner recesses. Yet something caused him to abandon his goal of colonization. Years later, he left the following words as he lay upon his deathbed. Never again must man tread upon the land of Ubuka. This epithet has been known throughout Adelin's history as the Ancient Pact. The Nakuals are bound by this very pact, but they are not the only ones. Do you see where I am heading?
So you mean Leafkin?
Yeah, right? Precisely. You see, Miro, the Leafkin do not look kindly on mankind's encroachment upon Ubuka, as it violates the word and spirit of the sacred deal they made with the Founder King. Its power is absolute. The only one who can nullify the pact would be the Founder King himself, or one of his bloodline. It was not comparably long ago that man respected this code to the same degree as the denizens of the forest, when the Order of Adelin was a royal force superseding all that is. His dying wishes were also engraved upon the sword that he once carried at his side. Throughout the centuries, each king of Adelin has held the sword high in front of his subjects, swearing to uphold his ancestors' grand promise. Your eyes widen in surprise, and I assure you every last syllable is steeped in truth. Throughout all of Adelin's history, her citizens only set foot in Ubuka on two occasions. The first, of course, was when the Founder King himself treaded upon the land. The second was in an age called the Great Expedition, a time when the Founder King's words had begun to fade from memory. The remnants of the encampments set up during that time still exist to this day on the shoreline of the Eastern Sea. Forgive me, my story has veered off in an unexpected direction. As I was explaining, throughout time, Adelin's rulers have always respected the pact. Whenever a new king ascended, He would take hold of the sword and swear a solemn oath to uphold that which had been passed down through the ages. Yet winds of change started to sweep the city, and the Order of Adlan was reorganized into one of 12 noble houses. When Ignis, the current leader of the Order of Adlan, came to power, he was just one man in charge of his house. His influence over the city muted at best. He chose to abandon the sword, declaring that the colonization of Vilbuca was to recommence, a stance not taken in well more than 24 generations. Thus a new age dawned upon the city, one of pioneering and progress. So, if he forsook the blade of his forefathers, into whose hands did it fall? Think hard, dear Miro. The one who possesses it is the one closest to Ignis himself, one present at his coronation. In fact, you have laid eyes upon the blade on more than one occasion.
It must be Arciela.
Precisely. The sword that our princess now wields is the only thing that represents the will of the Founder King himself. I profess that I have a tendency to ramble, but I assure this tale served to scatter the clouds of doubt that was surely meddling your thoughts. Think of it as a tidbit of wisdom from someone with idle hands and tongue. At my age, dreams are a thing of the past, as they have been for decades upon decades. Sometimes I catch myself thinking about the Founder King. All he wanted was to catch dreams in his hands. So he reached out into the depths of the forest, attempting to seize what no man had ever touched. At least, so go the stories that they tell. You adventurers cling to your desires in much the same way. No, forget what I just told you and leave me to my wanderings.
Why do I get the feeling that Teodor is related to the Founder King?
I don't know. Or that he is.
That was a possibility too. Alright, where are you?
Next to you.
Alright, I can't see you, so give us a chocobo jig. There you are. Alright, let's do this. Alright, so we are gonna head back to Neville in... I think we are officially on Chapter 2 now, Silly.
Excellent.
Chapter 2 of 5. This is what we're about to start, is Submission 1 with Submission 1, Sub-Submission 1.
Ah, I see.
Yeah, submissions have submissions in this expansion.
Damn.
This person's name is Hey, welcome back! Did you manage to find out anything? The Founder King's sword? Oh, you mean the one that the Princess Asiela always keeps at her side? You know how it happened to come into her possession? Ignis bequeathed it to her when he ascended to his current station. To think that such a blade would be a relic of centuries past. She guards it like a protective mother would guard her son. Never once has anyone seen her without it. You want to borrow it? Are you out of your mind? It must be really important for you to say something so rash. Oh-ho, so that's the rub. You think the Liefkin will trust you if you have the sword? Not that I expect you to give it up to some piece of hard candy, but if you want to try it, you can find the princess at Castle Adelin. Sure, it might be like wringing blood from a stone, but it's at least worth a shot. It's the only way to figure out what's going on wrong with the land.
Vanquish lizards.
Speaking of vanquishing lizards.
What?
Speaking of vanquishing lizards.
What about it?
We have vanquished lizards.
Yeah.
Alright, let's check this waypoint. Maybe we can get the one closest to the castle. Eastern Adelaide. Let's grab Castle Adeline Gates. Why do we have a Pokemon? What are you referring to, Yusuf? Oh, I stepped out and it gave me a cutscene immediately.
Not me.
Just walk towards the gate.
Oh, maybe it's giving me one.
You voiced this character, so...
That's right.
Oh, wait. Oh, I voiced her. Oh, heavens, this isn't good! No, 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 not good at all! Hmm? You there! I've seen you before, when looking in a mirror. Where was it? At the palace? At the place? The place with the thing? Oh, no matter, what was your name again? Miro, that's right, Miro. You're one of those pioneers everyone's been raving about. Do you have some business here, or... Oh, while I have you here, you wouldn't happen to see the princess, would you? Arcella, I mean. No? Oh, that's what I was afraid of. She must have put on her traveling clothes and headed off into the forest. She'd been muttering something about strange goings-on at the Aragon Locus at the Cerdus Caverns. Oh dear, you're not supposed to know that! I didn't tell you anything, and no one can prove that I did!
You just stand there stoically.
Sweet mercy, this is not a good day for me at all. You had a Charmander hat a few moments ago. I wish I had a Charmander hat.
It was when I put the Chocobo thing on your head, I think.
Oh. Yeah. Alright. Let's grab the home plane here. Okay, so we gotta figure out how to get to the Cerdus Cavern, silly. That is okay. Where we gotta go next. So we put the gates for cutscene. Alright. Cerdus Caverns. Do we have the map for this place? That's a good question. We definitely want the map for this place.
I thought we got 30,000 units. I guess 3,000 is still a lot, though.
Yeah, 3,000 is a lot.
So where do we want to go to?
We want to go to Cerdus Caverns. But to get there, we got to go... Yeah, we got to... Well, we already got the cutscene.
Oh, okay.
That's what we just got. Okay. So what we want to do is go to Cerdus. We got to go through Mo Gates, but we didn't have the map for Mo Gates, so let's see if we have the cutscene for this place, because... the cutscene, permit key items? Is that where our maps go?
Be? Might be.
No. Magical maps. Got the Esha Forest, okay, we got Foray to Hinatia, we got Rala Waterways. Okay, we do not have enough of the maps there. So I don't remember where we went to get the maps, do you?
The Pioneers Coalition was one place that had them, I think.
I think so. Okay, let's go there. Because we're going to need the map for Mogates in the next one. Western, okay, and we're going to go to... Pioneers Coalition. Yeah. Also, by the way, Silly and I were in Mo's Gate last night trying to do a side quest, or the other night, and we got killed by a bunch of Apex Matamatas. So, we gotta figure out how to get past those. I don't know if we're gonna run into them today. It looks like we have to go to a different area than that, but... Okay, so it was... This person?
I don't know. I don't know what that guy gives, what those things are.
I don't know. Demon? Okay, that's not it. There's coalition equipment. Find out here. Where to purchase? gonna cost bailed, but we got lots of bailed. Oh, we gotta buy it from Sifa Alani in Eastern Adelan.
Okay.
Sorry, everyone, this is a completely new area for us. We're still not sure where everything is.
We're not sure where things are in the old areas either.
That's not true. We know how to find the Sparks vendor and the vendor across the road to sell stuff to.
And the book from Northern Sandoria.
Oh yeah, and the book from Northern Sandoria. That's a good point. Adelan Isles. Eastern Adelan. Well, let's go to home point one, I guess. She says she's at F9. Or G6. Okay, so F9 should be really close then. Rough. Alright. Okay, she's in the Scouts Guild, that's right. Let's head down there.
Guess that makes sense.
Yeah. So I think our goal with Bailed should be to get all the maps first.
Mm-hmm.
Now that we got the weapon. There we go, Sifalani right here. Alright, let's get your show wield. Warm our basalt fields, alright.
That one?
I'm getting all of them that I can.
Okay. That makes sense.
Particularly, let's get Mole Gates and Sirtis Caverns, though.
Make sure we have those first.
Yeah.
Although, we may be able to just buy them all.
There's a good chance of that, yeah.
Oops.
That way we'd never run into issues with maps again. I made sure I got those, too, though. Well, I'm glad you're really enjoying this, Dad. I know we're not really doing anything yet, but we're going to be heading out here in just a moment. My dad set his laptop up with a cord to his TV. So he's watching us on his big screen TV. I can hear it a lot better now.
What would we be if we couldn't provide accurate maps? Dad, that's what.
Well, we'd be dead. They'd probably be okay. There we go. I got all of them. Alright. There. Now, let's head up to the waypoint. Yes, Yusuf, my dad is watching our stream. He watches every stream unless he's got a doctor's appointment or something. Alright, so are you ready to take another adventure into Mo Gates? Normally, we don't go places off stream that we've never been before, but. Because we needed to get rep with Adelan to go on a 48-inch monitor. Yeah. Anyway, because we needed rep with Adelan, we decided that we would do it, but unfortunately, it did not go so well. We got murdered. You ready, silly?
Mm-hmm.
Crabbed up. There you go. Alright. Yusuf, doesn't your dad watch your streams? So, I've noticed something about these areas is they're all extremely large, but they're all just winding paths too. So it makes it hard to explore them. Aw, damn it. Alright. Let's do this.
What happened? Oh no. There's a fence in the way.
Make it a little faster. We'll resummon the guys I was gonna use. Just in case. Yeah, that's a crab we're riding. Rideable crabs, that's a thing. Oh, so we have to do one of these for this mission? Hopefully we have the ability. He doesn't like video games, he only likes Wii Sports. Oh, that's too bad. But yeah, we have to do one of these for this mission. I don't know if it requires us to have a special item or not. I assume not. Nobody mentions it. Have you killed this knotted root yet?
Not yet.
Ah, Koromurus, that's casting refresh too. Ruga Gene has been defeated. Oh yeah. Take forever to kill these damn knotted roots. Look at a Benzio go, he's just smashing it.
Nice.
Silky Kittens and Toon Monk, are you guys still viewing? Benji already is below. Oh, that's great. Target that knotted root for some reason. Oh, yeah. We're gonna have to kill the monsters and the ones in the Sirtis Caverns, apparently.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I don't know if they can kill us, but it's highly recommended.
How much did my shark bite just sit for?
2028.
Not bad.
Alright. Let's ride the crab. Well, that's out of the way, quite literally. We're gonna get to go someplace new on today's stream. Assuming I'm going the right way. Alright. So the Yossi Hunting Grounds and the Czak Battlegrounds both look pretty much the same to me. I don't really see much difference between the two. So, one of the polls I did last night on Nagaraja, I started it, and all of my trust just instantly died. But I didn't take any damage.
That's funny.
Yeah, that got hit by his glacial breath, I think.
Oh no.
I thought you had all of them. Rahal stayed alive. Alright. That's right, we gotta go down here. Alright, please, please don't let us get murdered.
Oh, I have a solution for that.
Yeah, you can just run away like an asshole.
Don't worry, I'm with you.
Jerk. Then let's bring out. The map music in this game is so freaking good. I know Toonlock, isn't it? Silly and I can't help but gush over how awesome the music is.
It's good.
Alright, so Silly, we kind of died up in the upper parts there. We gotta get to the Mormor baseball fields? Maybe? No, because it says that the way through is from the Mo Gates. So let me just open up Sirtis Caverns here and see where the entrances are from. Yeah, so it says Mo Gates is one of the entrances to this area. Okay.
Okay.
So how do we get there? Mo Gates at M5. Okay, so if we look at M5. Well, that can't be true. So it's got to be down on the second map for this place. Let me go back to Mo Gates real quick and see if there's more than one map. Oh yeah, there is more than one map. And is M5 someplace you can get to? No, M5 is not even a place you can get to on that one. What the fuck? Ah, I see the entrance to it, okay. It's not at M5, it's at D11. What the hell is this guide saying? It's at... Oh, it's Mogates. Okay, I see what it's saying. M5 on the Sirtis Caverns map. That makes sense. Okay, so it's not that far from us, Silly, so hopefully we don't run into any Apex monsters to murder us. When will I stream some FF with my dad? Probably never. Sharp thorns protrude from the surface. Oh, don't tell me we have to go all the way around. But it's a scalable area!
Rude. What the hell?
I'll have to look that up later. Alright, I'm worried about going to the northern parts of this map because of all of the Apex monsters we ran into. But we don't have to go to the right, so it's possible we'll just bypass them. Yeah, so those of you who don't know, Apex monsters are apparently like super monsters they added to the game to give some good EXP bonuses to people. But the problem is, the ones we ran into murdered us.
That's true.
Like, quite horribly. I couldn't even hit it.
Okay, you need like super high accuracy to hit. Hello, I'd like to target the menacing mantis now. Hit it.
So if anybody has any advice on how to defeat Apex Matamatas, that would be excellent, other than get more accuracy noob, because that's the plan. But you want to fight? Writhing like Dula? Abdella? Fortunately, we cannot ride mounts here.
It's true. Why does everything want to fight you?
Good question. Maybe if you get a Nintendo Switch. Yeah. Maybe. Depends. On what Dragon Quest games we get for the Switch. Yeah, I'll just dodge past these guys real quick. Yeah, we're this way again. Yeah, I know you want to fight. Alright, we're gonna turn and kill these now. Oh, we only got one. That's not bad. Where are you, son?
I'm here.
Hiding again.
Yeah, of course. Got a merit point.
Alright. Excellent. You have 15 total now. Okay, so here were these conflagrant Irushas, if you remember.
Mm-hmm.
Dodge around them. One of them aggroed someone. Okay, let's get up past this one. Well, the Switch brings one to that. Oh, well, the Switch is already getting Dragon Quest 11, 10, and Heroes and Heroes 2, but how many of those make it to North America is anyone's guess. See you later.
Yeah, good job.
Alright, this might be where we ran into the Apex Monomatas. Actually, I think that may have been off to the right. We don't have to go to the right, though. We have to run to the left here. Mortimer baseball fields just make me think of Mortimer from Dragon Quest XI. Or, not Dragon Quest XI, Dragon Quest VI. Remember Mortimer, the end boss of VI?
Mm-hmm.
And how I went and beat Nocturnus, and then he went and beat up Mortimer?
I like that part.
It was pretty awesome. It was a nice little scene they threw in there. Alright, there's a disturbed Matamata, but that's not an Apex Matamata, so we don't have to worry about that one. He can be disturbed all he wants. This is the right way? Yes. Alright. Then we just follow the path down. Plus, doesn't have to be multiplayer. That's true. I could just get you on to commentary. Huh, here's a Reeve. Alright, so we should probably take out the enemies first.
Okay.
Oh, I can hit this one! It's already going better. This is a Matamata, so it can stun with hits. Scoriaceous Clot. Oh, that's a lovely name.
Let's go.
It's under Fablinks and Balinrel.
Oh, we killed the other
thing. The Matamata's dead. Oh, I was too strong for it. That's 6 years I'm going for. Hopefully we don't need anything special for these birds.
Yeah, right. We'll find out in a second.
Alright, let's do this. No, okay, good. Oh, there's a Matamata hitting us. I'll kill it after we kill the Nana Dubrat. Okay. Yeah. Oh, never mind, he's dead. Somehow.
My AoE, probably.
Yeah. Guess I'm attacking the knotted root. Apparently foot blinks with like additional effects with its attacks. Trying to see what it is, but it's going by too fast. Here's just additional damage. Yeah, it looks like it's just additional damage. I'll save you from those there once I kill this fruit. I only got 8% health left. It's dead. Oh, yeah. I got a Lavarian and a handful of iron sand.
Yeah, same. I don't know.
Looks like a... Okay. Crap, probably a crafting item. So our homework for next week will be to figure out how to get upscale scaling points. Pungent fungus. That's a great name. A mining point. I've noticed Adeline has a lot more mining points and stuff.
Yeah, you know, that's true. Mm-hmm.
The Soracious Clot. I think one of the Magrodos, maybe.
Oh no.
Maybe not. Maybe it's just moving. No. Oh, it looks good. Okay. Might get aggro by Natchi Knox Scottens. Guess not. Ferocious Fungor. Alright, this one will probably aggro. These two. We'll probably aggro. Alright, let's do it. We don't know what's coming up, so we may as well fight them.
That's true. Alright.
So make sure you're spending your sparks on the chapters 6 through 9 of the Rem's Tales.
Mm-hmm.
They're 15,000 apiece, but we need them, so.
That's true, yeah.
And we can just make time to do the Sacred Circle. Sacred Crest, Notorious Monsters.
Oh, Nero wasn't having that guy.
Went up along the edge here. Hope we can avoid the oozes. Alright, so since we didn't run in and get murdered by Apex Matamatas, this place is actually kind of neat looking.
Yeah.
Well, like the roots and stuff growing through the wall.
Mm-hmm.
You wouldn't really expect in an area that's got magma. Alright, we made it to Sardis Caverns. Is there anything?
Nice.
I do possess a map of this place. Fuck you. Okay, so there doesn't appear to be any home points or anything else, but look at this map, silly.
Alright, hang on. Oh, cool.
Alright, let's get our chest set. I don't know what's here, so we're not gonna chance it and not bring chests.
This is not a fun place to be. There's too many places we can go. I'm
also gonna look at our handy dandy BG Wiki guide and see if it tells me where to go. Where's Kormar? Alright. So, our guide says we gotta go to... you recently been clear. If it has recently been cleared, you don't have to complete the mission. It's talking about the... Okay, clear the colonization reef at E9. Now, if it's already been there, we don't need to do it. So, E9 is right here. And, okay, so we gotta go way the fuck over there. Alright. That's gonna be fun to figure out. Well, alright, so Lee, you ready for this?
Yeah.
Alright, let's see if we can figure this out. This place is a maze! Well, they definitely wanted to give people a lot of area to explore.
Yeah, seriously.
Here. So I'm gonna be looking at my map quite a bit to figure out if we're going it the right way. I have a path in my mind that I think might work, but we don't know until we get there. Kind of miss Adilas. Yeah, she's probably gonna aggro us, that's fine.
No.
Once we get through this area, I'll turn and fight them. Alright. We got two of them. Alright.
Okay.
I can handle this. Alright, Corilla, we're trusting you. Do that tank thing. Yeah, Corilla, before pumping a tank cooldown, you may want to actually pick up Thread.
Yeah, what the hell?
That's one down. Alright, let's give this a dragon kick. Didn't even look like a kick. Sharkbite did quite a bit of damage. Hey, another merit point. Congrats.
How much did it do?
4,000.
Not bad.
And mine only did 1,111, so I guess Dragon Kick's not good on those. Okay, so that is not the way I wanted to go. Damn it. Alright, let's try this again. I'm sure that way would work, it's just not exactly conducive to what I wanted to go. So let's go this way. There we go. Hey, this kind of reminds us back when we didn't know how to get around at all, so...
Yeah.
Me just blindly leading us places and like, alright, let's try this direction. What? How the fucking thing aggress? That was rude. Alright, well... Foreboding Fungars. At least it's not an Apex Fungar.
I can't dislodge myself from the back of your body now. I got stuck.
Wow. That's unfortunate.
There we
Yusuf
go.
Likes the map too. This one's probably gonna arrow as well, so let's kill it. Yeah. Oh, and you know what, silly?
What?
Reached the end of this video.